So, Lamar, when we think about the ReadSpeaker solution at your institution, do you just solely use it for disability services for those students needing accommodation, or do you use it campus-wide?
You know, we're like a lot of institutions, I'm sure. We create courses in our LMS for every course we offer, whether it's automotive technology, welding, history, English, accounting. They all get a course created, and those faculty are strongly encouraged to put documents in there, whether it's a syllabus or lecture notes or practice quizzes or study guides, whatever it may be. And again, the beauty of ReadSpeaker is it just shows up, you know, just shows up in those documents. And so, again, the students can read the documents or they can listen to the documents. And so, you know, it's really out there for every student.
Perfect. Because with ReadSpeaker, we really like to follow the methodology of the universal design of learning, and, you know, for all students, not just for a few. So that's good to know that it is available to all of your students at the college. Let's jump to things like math and STEM content, and even quizzes. How important is it, in your opinion, for a text-to-speech product to be able to read that type of content?
I mean, it's critical because we have so many students taking those courses. I mean, you can't get a college degree without math. And STEM is becoming more and more prevalent, you know, in society, in our economy, in our schools. And so, you know, if you can't handle that, I mean, you're going to have a tough time making it as a company. Mm-hmm. So the fact that you guys have got that working as well as it does, I mean, is huge, because again, you know, a third to 50% of the students are going to be taking some kind of math class. And, you know, for it to be able to handle that is very, very important.
Perfect. Do you guys use a proctoring solution on campus?
We do. We're currently using HonorLock. Mm-hmm. And you know, we had one little glitch when we first started with ReadSpeaker. You know, you turn it on and you don't realize all the bells and whistles it has, because it's got a lot of them. But one of them is dictionary. And so when the quiz popped up, there was a little icon that said dictionary. And so if there was a vocabulary test, the students were, they're pretty smart. They clicked on this thing called dictionary and they just saw the definition of it. So we had to quickly go in and turn that off, you know, in the quizzes. But again, in a class setting, in a document, being able to click on that little dictionary link and let students kind of, you know, because that's one of those things, they don't want to ask a question in the classroom, what does that word mean? Because, you know, they may think everybody's looking at them or laughing at them or whatever, but when you're in an online environment, you just click on a link and it says dictionary and it gives you the definition of the word. That's very helpful. It's just not very helpful on a test.
Yeah. And we actually made that change in the new quizzing feature in D2L to make sure that is not turned on. So yeah. Good note. And when we think about, you know, you mentioned some people just don't want to ask a question in front of the other student, you know, that really goes into even at the college level, a lot of students don't self-identify as needing accommodations, whether it be because they just don't feel comfortable doing it or if it's a financial reason. So again, having those tools for everybody, you know, whether or not they identify as needing accommodation, it's a great, you know, great feature. So Lamar, as we wrap up, what advice would you give to other educators or, you know, even IT directors, when we're thinking about a text-to-speech product and we're talking about accessibility tools, and even when we're thinking about your role in vertical education that is specifically about, you know, specializing and making sure that these institutions have these things available, you know, for these audits, what advice do you have for those out there that are, may still be shopping around, that haven't yet thought that maybe they need these things at their institution? What are your thoughts?
I mean, the biggest thought is keep it simple. You know, again, faculty are excellent at teaching. I mean, they know their material inside and out, but they don't necessarily know technology. And so again, the thing about ReadSpeaker is, you know, it's almost like magic. You know, we do the work on the back end and get it set up in the LMS, and it just shows up for the faculty. And so it makes it simple for them. They don't have to go in and try to figure out how do I code this in HTML so it'll work. It just works. It works on a Word document or it works on a PDF document. You know, so again, simplicity, when it's simple, the faculty are going to buy in. And when the faculty buy in, it makes everybody's job a lot easier. So, you know, there's other products out there, but I've yet to find one that's as simple to use as ReadSpeaker. So, you know, again, we can go into a lot more than that. But again, that for me, that was one of the biggest selling points is it's almost you turn it on and it does what it's supposed to do. And it just doesn't give you any problems. You know, we don't ever have anybody call and saying, ReadSpeaker's not working. ReadSpeaker's not handling this document. It just works. And that's the beauty of the product.